Hello, my name is Zach Pilgrim. My project is on drought analysis in Chennai, India. Chennai is the capital of the southernmost state in India. The drought that I'm going to be analyzing started in 2017 from lower than normal amounts of precipitation during the 2016 monsoon season. Each year following has had lower and lower amounts of precipitation. Due to the nature of when and where this project focuses on, I had to use Landsat 8 Level 2 data, and the dates that I'm using are both from late April, one in 2016 and one in 2019. This is my first literature review. I think they gave a really good background on how droughts happen and how monitoring them has changed over the last 50 years. They compared the different techniques from hundreds and hundreds of different papers and found that largely NDVI is the most common way that people monitor drought. But they suggested using a combination of indices to get a more accurate idea of the drought. The reason I chose this paper was because of their descriptions on why you would use what index and where and how you're able to combine all of them. In this paper, they were trying to create a method for monitoring drought in Central Asia. They created a variable weight system that helps to classify this specific area so that they would be able to monitor it more effectively. I was planning to do something similar to this and create my own weighted variable model, but I was not able to find enough data to actually recreate this in any meaningful way. For this paper, they studied an area that had a mix of dense forests, cropland, and tended and untended forests, and this paper took place over a 7-year period, so they were able to monitor the area during both drought and normal conditions. They use something called the Alexi and the Disalexi model, which is basically just a combination of Landsat and MODIS and created what they called a STAR-FM model. I wanted to try and use a similar temporal aspect in my project, but like I said earlier, finding usable data for this area turned out to be a fairly difficult task. Okay, so this is my unsupervised classification. The one on the left is from before the drought, and the one on the right is from during the drought. I used the same six classes for both of these images. You can see the one on the left from before the drought has a lot more vegetation and a lot more water throughout, and the one on the right is much drier and is missing many of the different reservoirs. This started with 80 classes. I then used a dendrogram to find most similar groups and combined them down to just six classes: water, urban, vegetation, barren, barren and pavement, and cultivated. In figure A and B, you can see a close-up of the actual city in Chennai and three of their reservoirs. In A, you can see how much more vegetation is there as well. In B, there's almost no vegetation and their reservoirs have almost completely dried up. The yellow is supposed to be cultivated, and I think that's partly a misclassification from where vegetation used to be. This is my supervised classification. After spending far more time on these than I would actually like to admit, I'm not super happy with their outcome. On the left in 2016, you can see there's a large amount of misclassification with water, and on the right, there's a large amount of misclassification with cultivated. When I did this classification, I made over 100 different training samples for each category. I used random trees as my classifier. In figure A, you can see the three main reservoirs, and in B, they're almost completely gone. Overall, in regards to water, B, your 2019 came out more accurate, but it classified a lot as either urban or cultivated that wasn't. And in A, your 2016, it classified a lot as water, and I'm not sure what it was picking up instead of water. This is my Sentinel data. I wasn't able to get the same exact dates as I have for my Landsat data, but they're only about a month later for each of the two. This is the same three reservoirs that I showed in my previous two slides. On the left, you can see how much more full they are in 2016, versus on the right, you can just barely see the water in some of them. This is Sentinel-1 data. I used the Snap toolbox to actually process the data, and I went through a few different steps to clean it up a bit from the raw image you can see in figure A compared to figure B. And to help contrast the water a little bit, I ran that formula you can see below. The last step I did was terrain correction, but I didn't really find any actual difference in doing that step. But I did not have the DEM of the area, so I just used default elevation data that's provided within the Snap toolbox. I also ran a lot of different indices on the data to try and find what would be the most effective way to show the impact of the drought. I ran an NDVI, a SAVI, an MNDWI, an AWEISH, SR, VARI, and the Red Edge NDVI. For this project, I was mostly just focused on water levels, so I mainly focused on the MNDWI and the AWEISH. This is a comparison of MNDWI and the AWEI. I found that the AWEI was a little bit better at identifying water than the MNDWI. After deciding to focus on the AWEI, I then reclassified the before and after images with everything below zero as one class and everything above zero as the other. This separated the water from everything else in the image. I then used the minus tool and made this image on the right. The black is where the water is in 2019, and white is where the water was in 2016. Here are some of the other indices that I made. My NDVI and SAVI were also both pretty clear about the impact of the drought, but since I was focused on water and these are better for vegetation health, I focused on the other two. To wrap up, I was pleasantly surprised with my unsupervised classification. I wasn't quite as happy with my supervised, but in all fairness, I need to spend more time getting familiar with it. For future research, I would definitely say focus on smaller, less diverse areas, not the entire image like I tried to do. So that's also probably part of the issue with the supervised classification. And here are my sources. Thank you.